And the simple reason is that funds that are paid for EDC get diverted to different activities, not related to the project. And in the process, projects suffer. On two projects as experimental measures being produced, that they will not pay, firstly, we will not have the same person or the same entity as the promoter and EDC company. But I knew that the backdoor, the connection continued. So we revised the second thing that we will pay against the supplier, direct to the supplier, instead of paying to the EPC contractor or to the developer. And that worked reasonably well. Supplies arrived in time. The construction work started. The construction contractors were paid again directly by PFC. It was fantastic. So basically, the basic merit lies in the what you call the operational parameters and the procedures. And once you correct that and you pay against the supplies, pay against the work done, nobody will get it. Right. Because every year contractor, every supplier wants his payments to be done on time. Once you pay them on time, the clause of early completion bonus guarantee, they say is of how fast I can do it and how much bonus I can get. So that is all. If any, you say the public sector may be not possible or not possible, always there. Efficiency, good performance never gets better.
Right.
The only means required. So that's where the, this is after having seen almost more than 100 projects at Orbit, and equal number of projects more than that have been funded in PFC. And prior to that, having seen in ONGC, because I had the charge of ONGC, Hazira Gas Processing Plant for a year. Though I was general manager of finance, but still I had a charge, I controlled the whole plant with all the chief engineers reporting. And we found that it was excellent way to work, and all the targets that were given, my work completed almost a month before.
Right.
Because the contractors were there, and there was a stage when there was a flood and everything was washed out, mud filled, labor had run away because of the plague. So it was a big problem how to get back the labor. Can you get it from Odisha? I had the labor flown by air. And this contractor, this is how much money I'm giving. My per day ka gas ka loss is so much. And we had it. Similarly, the projects which are being done by DU of Korea. So because of this, the main big project was behind Shin. Now again, the problem was how to get it. I said, okay, it doesn't matter, you get it airfreight. Airfreight se mangaya, cost economics worked out. I found it was cheaper and more efficient and more profitable to have air lifted rather than waiting for the ship to come and the ship in general to me.
Opened up.
Opened up. That's it.
Right. So, this is one side. You know, basically, you address issues of delay and technical problems. But I want difficult staff to push because hydro mein bade delay hain aur iske karan sabko pata hai. Lekin what is the way forward that these kind of important projects like hydro come up in reasonable time? Some delays will be there. Like now we are seeing Subhanshin was to be commissioned in 2023, finally they said it will be done. But ab wo phir 25 se tak ja rahi hai. 24 aur 25 ki kahani hai. So these things keep happening. Some kind of geological surprises, some kind of flood challenges keep coming. So sir, is there any way that these delays are not long beyond it? Like Pune Sanchi now has literally been delayed, you know, in Bhutan. You know, so it has been hanging fire. अब वो कल सुन रहे हैं कि पुनः साल जो टू तो आ जाएगी इसमें काम बट वन स्टिल हैंग्स फॉर सो व्हाट इज योर पर्पस बिकॉज द फंडर्स आर मोर वरीड ये जो डिले जो है इनके पैसे कैसे दिए जाए।
Well, according to me, the delays are mainly because of the delay in decision-making. In corporate sector, in NDBC, when we started the priority award for term, the information was obvious. They were very confident. The geological conditions were very tough. We did not anticipate to that extent that what could be the technology which has been deployed to make the turning point. When such a situation arose, the contractor wanted the decision, it took proper time. It is a waste of time. And once the decision was taken, the opening machine was done. The situation took about 2 to 3 years to tackle that exception geological occurrence. This was Natha Dhabi project. We started the Natha Dhabi project in 92 and it was mission only to the after 11 years. Well, an example of Tara, we did the same mistake. We contemplated in Himalayan conditions, geological conditions are very tough for any kind of problems. We again failed to contemplate that special equipment is required to make the tunneling through by the contractors. The decision was taken, I always say, decisions have been taken yesterday, not today. From the government side in Tara, we could manage the decision taken in yesterday. We see that time of 1 year, we can just get an authority. And imports were done, machine were done, the tunneling was going through, but it took a lot of time. The third example is Karcha Mountain, the tunnel project. The same is similar kind of tunneling conditions. We anticipated that we cannot push through the tunnel unless we have the equipment right on the day one. Even if I don't get such tunneling conditions, I should have the operation equipment available right on the day one. You will be surprised to know we got the tunneling condition difficult again. We did not lose even 24 hours to put the equipment and we put the project 1000 megawatt. Tara project was 1020, Natha Dhabi was 15,000. Where we wasted time, we did not waste even a day on Karcha Mountain. And we commissioned the project quite well at the original schedule of 6 years. When people talk of tunneling conditions, I said you give me any kind of tunneling conditions in conventional way. I don't talk of tunnel boring machines. In conventional way, I don't need a day one extra from you to commission. We have the expertise, we have the way, we should have the equipment available right on day one. ISRF has talked of the delays in Parvati, in Uttarakhand projects. Well, the delay has been again only 2 reasons. Decision taking and the insistence of the government departments to put the tunnel boring machine in Parvati or in Iranya or in Uttarakhand projects. Here in Himalayan, most of the projects, you cannot use TBM. You have to do the conventional drill and blast and you will be through. I talked to the Parvati people about 8 to 10 years earlier. I said to give it to me and have your project in conventional way and forget about your machine which is buried there. Your project will be commissioned. It is not commissioned till today. The delay is because of decision taken, especially on the government side and the corporation, whatever. Decision taking has to be very fast. That is a waste of time. And secondly, the equipment anticipation has to be very strong. The equipment is like a surgical operation. When you go to a hospital, all kind of equipment are available. If you want to save the patient, any patient can be done without waste of time. So similar kind of equipment is required to tackle the chronic difficulties. And no time will be wasted, I can assure you that. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I want to extend this question in a different dimension to Anandeshwar sir, with another hydro standard. So now going beyond this, Kutcha Mantu was a finishing time, in fact, 4 saal mein usne aaya 4 saal 4 saal and even Tala was finished in quick time, right sir? If I'm not mistaken, there were barely any delays. Other than
what you did, it is same, but you can't say
we. Yeah, it is not, it can't be calculated in detail. So I'm saying, sir, now why this kind of a strategy cannot be applied? Even SJVN project, if you take the timeline, it was finished in time. But that agri gave me reasonable time with all challenges. So can you throw some light on few of those challenges and also that whether this will keep coming to the geology in Himalaya? We have to live with it.
According to me, geology cannot be made.
Yes, but it will come. But what I'm saying, you have to live with it.
How to be dealing with the nature in a friendly and cooperative way.
Right. So, Mr. Sir.
You see that the question which you have asked me,
yeah.
I will say it's a very difficult question. So, I would like to answer it first philosophically and then practically. See, to construct any project, what do we need? We need technology. Technology is available. You can get the technology, pay for it, they will be there. You may have the people also who know the job, they will come, you can employ them. You need finance. Finance is also available, you have to either get put your money or you can borrow funds and that finance can come. Data available. Then you need project management, the people who have to implement it. Implementation has got the one thing that how to organize the job, how to make the payments, and to operate the contract. After that, there is another angle, another thing, which is known as character. Character is not available in the market, on sale. Nobody can purchase it. Nobody can say that you take it and now you are having good character. I am not blaming anybody. I am not saying that people don't, I am not saying anything should not be constituted in any other manner. But the only thing is that to construct any project, the commitment of the company, its people, its top management, the people who are the, you know, who matter, all these things is very important and their own character is very important. Then the things move properly. You see what happens that when you start any project, normally what you are talking that either the project should be EPC or the project could be item rate based, mostly these are the two,
yeah.
Particularly. EPC contracts, some people say it is panacea. You just give it and everything will happen. As Dr. Ware told that it does, it is not so.
Right.
Reason is that you can have the EPC contract where you have got a lot of certainties, where uncertainties are lesser.
Correct.
You know the topography, you know the geology, you know most of the things, and the uncertainties are less. There the EPC contracts are successful, they will be successful. But where it is not, EPC contracts will not succeed. Then the question is that you have got two parties, one party who has to get the work executed, other party has to execute the job, whom we call contractor. Unfortunately, in our system, the contractor is not considered as the partner. He is not considered to be coming from the same family.
Right.
The people who talk to the contractor, very well, the people start saying, oh, there is something wrong. But the question that is here, that we should say that we are partner in progress.
Good.
I tell you, one of these things, I went to meet Dr. E. Shridharan. That was my first meeting.
Mm-hmm.
When I went there, I went to his chair, I touched his feet. He said, what are you doing?
Mm-hmm.
I said, sir, I have come only to touch your feet.
Mm-hmm.
No other agenda, nothing else. We sat together. When I was coming out, you know what did he say to me? He said, Mr. Mishra, You can succeed in any project only if your contractor succeeds. This is the thing what he told me.
100%.
Perfect.
That is the thing which you have to learn. But unfortunately, this particular thing is missing in most of the projects. And other thing is that contract operation, contract is given to so many people are operating the contract. Unfortunately, those people, many of the people don't know what is in the contract. I give you one example. I was posted at Seva Hydroelectric Project as head of the project. I went there and the penstock work was going on. Our penstock contractor was not being paid. People came and told me, there, this is the clause, the payment is not being done. Sir, we cannot make the payment. That person has done a lot of job. Then I read the clause, because I had been contract for a long time before that. I just wrote down, I just gave the instruction, this is the clause, this is like this, and make the payment. The things changed completely. The person who was in his head office, Calcutta, he just came to meet who is that person who has come and started making payment.
Right.
So this is very important, that what type of leadership is given to the project, what message we are sending. Like in Rampur when I went, at that time World Bank has told this project will get delayed by 3 years. Right. It's in writing. And when I joined there, you see, that people say, what did you do? Actually, I did nothing except doing a few things. Number one, I strengthened the monitoring. Every day morning, the progress was coming on my mobile, and I was asking, if I find something, I will talk to the person. I did not hesitate as a director even to talk to the junior engineer. Number two, what I did? I saw that the contractor's payments are released.
Right.
Many extra items are lying. I told that up to 35 crores is my power. You put up the files. People started putting the files and everything was cleared. And the payment started flowing. Then the contractors were, there are certain problems. You see that it's not so. That sometimes the contractors head office, they don't support. Unfortunately, there are problems in the contractors organization also.
Yes.
And those problems, I was talking to their head, to their MD and everybody. And sometimes I feel even after talking, I'm not getting the result. So what we did even, that we said that you are making the payment, there is a clause that you have to make the payment, say, on the 56th day, within 56 days.
Right.
Somebody interpreted it, make the payment on the 56th day.
Oh my.
Because I am losing. I said that, how are you losing? If you are making the payment, that person is making, but the progress is taking faster. More than the interest you earn, more than that you are getting. I said, why not that the contractor gives you the bill? You just seal cursory and make him 80% of the payment.
Yes.
If he charges extra, we will punish him. Even the material which was coming, we got it approved from the board. Then the material comes, it reaches to his shop, his PC, then we release some of the amount to the supply itself. And many things started changing. So you have to see wherever all these things are employed, because you see that nobody can give the prescription there to do it. Everywhere the circumstances are different. And one more thing in Hyderabad project, I tell you, the local problems, the administration, local administration, how much helpful they are.
Right.
Political. Many times the local administrators become politicians.
Yes.
And they create a lot of problems. Many times the problems are created which could have been avoided, but they are there. Then we put it in some other form and tell the Zahab, ye ho gaya, rock gir gayi, mein ho gaya. As he said, I always say geological surprises. I said, I hate what geological surprises.
Right.
There could be geological adversity, but not geological surprises. Whatever happens, you know everything. So the things are complex, but still there are certain ideas by which you can compress the time, you can avoid the. And if there is any problem for that, as he said very rightly, that you have to take a quick decision. Like in Rampur project, there was that outlet, there was a fall. In the morning, I received a call that said, it's a fall. I said, okay, don't worry. Now you start working how to restore it. And I tell you, within the same time, almost with a delay of 1 or 2 months, and within the same cost, we restored everything. What was the estimated cost of it? But for that, you need that type of team, the people. So, I will say that what I used to say everywhere, the character is one of the very important things. If the people are thinking on that line, then many things can be solved.
Thanks, sir.
Thanks.
In fact, obviously the question will now proceed to Baba sir. We had today morning itself, so something like we can discuss that we saw a structure literally collapsing at the Terminal 1 of the Mumbai Airport and made by GMR, the best companies in airport construction in the country. That way, I would say it's one of the best because the other company, unfortunately, this airport in Mumbai is now in Adani's, and I hope that Adani's can also show new airports and maybe 10 more companies can come in the airport business. But this is important. We have some fine airport construction. This is also an awarded airport. We have awarded Mumbai, Delhi, both GVK Adani got our awards also, Asibatan, as good airports in the world. They have been also listed in world awards. So what has happened for T1? That this whole thing literally collapsed like nine pins. So what is Bhavasab's take on this?
Right, good question. And the had I not joined, probably I would have been answering this at NDTV because there were frequent reminders coming. I'm sorry, but they would have asked the same question, and my answer would have been the same even if I am sitting on a TV or sitting over here, right? Airports are very glittering examples of infrastructure development.
Exactly.
Airports are very sensitive place. I tell people it are more sensitive than hospitals.
Yes.
Airport. The moment you enter the airport, there is a sort of an emergency on the mind of everybody who comes to the airport because we don't take flight for pleasure. We take flight because we have condemned road, we have condemned rail, and we have given preference to travel by air. So airports are very sensitive infrastructure. Now, off late, what we are looking at the airport when we go, we are looking for glass and steel structure. But we should see what is behind that.
Right.
And everybody is working on making the passenger happy. We openly say that everybody is trying to win over the unique passenger experience. And unique passenger experience comes from that he is getting a good coffee, he is getting a good service. But is he safe or not? Passenger is not asking. He is not bothered. Why? Because he thinks that I am in safe hand, they will take care of me and additional services I want. The moment a child is in the lap of his mother, he is not worried. We have lost that parenthood when we go to that infrastructure. Now, why that infrastructure has fallen? It is not new to me. I have been in trade, and I am remembered only when such things happen. Otherwise, no one calls me. So, emergency exigency is my forte. So at that time, what we do, we give some convincing replies, and then we try to show that the media hype is hidden under the carpet, and then we become happy. And after that, if I go to any boss, sir, now I have managed this, and now you do the corrective, he says, chodo na yaar, ab ho gaya, ab agli baar phir dekhenge. So then we wait for another falling of infrastructure. So that's what is happening. Now why this happened? This Terminal 1 was old infrastructure, and as I mentioned, they would have repaired it, and they would have not known that old means that you must do the X-ray scanning, whether the legs are weak, whether is the inside there is something crippled, but no, they give the cosmetic treatment and everybody was happy. And there are pressures. Infrastructure should not lie idle, and infrastructure should be economical. And why should we spend so much if it can, so much glittering can be done in people's work? That would have happened that way. And then there have been some quick fixes available which people are started using. And it is not that this airport is an old airport. It still survived. There are examples, even the new infrastructure was created and they have flown with the wind.
Yes.
The roofs have flown with the wind. Why? Because they were not tropicalized. We import material and we don't tropicalize the material which we are using. Right, so that is very important. And sometimes we avoid the curing material. If the baby has to take 9 months to take birth, we must give mother 9 months. We do not push for early delivery. And we say, nahi, jaldi karo, flight is late ho jayegi, aur VIP moment hai, flane, kisi minister ka janam de raha hai, koi inko acceleration de raha, us din tak aapko karna hi karna hai. So I have seen airports being developed, the whitewash has been done and they will make the whitewash to dry by putting the heaters, by being hot floor and raat ko lagaya, so way decoration bhi karna hai. Like that. So that's why what we tell at airports, everything should be safety and security is the prime forte of the aviation. That everybody is paying for that.
Right, sir.
Everybody, passenger is paying for that, and passengers shall demand for that. And passenger, we should the moment we enter the airport, we feel that we are scared, but that is being challenged. And then, so far as the airports are concerned, airports are in question for many reasons. Now, since we are sitting for renewability and sustainability subjective, and airports are always criticized for creating pollution, for creating noise pollution, and maybe this noise pollution and environmental pollution has reached our cities very late. But when I joined service in 79-80, at that time when I used to go abroad, and there used to be a very, very hype noise pollution, and because there used to be cargo, there used to be curfew in those countries. You cannot take up the flights night beyond 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock, whatever, depending city to city. And here we will welcome them. क्या फर्क पड़ता है 12 बजे हमारे को नॉइज से कुछ नहीं फर्क पड़ता उनको सब कुछ फर्क पड़ता है दे विल पुट ए कर्फ्यू एंड वी विल वेलकम दैट वहीं से हमारी फाउंडेशन खराब हो गई वी आर नॉट बीन कंसर्न अबाउट द एनवायरमेंटल सस्टेनेबिलिटी एंड दैट फाउंडेशन इज नाउ हैविंग अ मल्टीप्लायर इफेक्ट एंड प्रॉब्ली दैट्स द रीजन वी नीड सच काइंड ऑफ नो सेमिनार डिबेट्स एटसेट्रा बट आई थिंक ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम Since now, environmental has taken such an important aspect because aviation is such field that it is not limited to domestic. हम अकेले aviation नहीं चला सकते.
It's the whole world.
Aviation is an international concept.
Absolutely.
We are a global market creator. Why any country needs aviation? Because we are connecting people. And by one, the moment we connect two countries, multiple countries, then those country norms come into being. And ICAO, International Civil Aviation Organization, which is UN body, they control and govern. So that is the reason now they have taken four strong point that we should be eco-friendly and we should be technically sound and we should not be creating unnecessary waste and we should be we should be carbon neutral. So all those things which were being done voluntarily, but now we are coming to us as a matter of regulation. So we are being governed and things like that. And it is the duty and responsibility of the regulator has become more important. And I think gradually things like that, discussion like that will make passengers more aware, more demanding. And that's what I think.